After the launch of the fifth gen, we kind of took a step back and really evaluated the way that we're developing products. We were listening to customers, our processes around design and engineering. We'd see the printers in classrooms and see them being put in a different room where they weren't as easy to access, but their people were doing that because of the noise from the printer, for instance. And so there's a lot of little interesting things we picked up on in that contextual research that helped inform our thinking in the development of the Replicator Plus.
Being able to have everything from your desktop software to your slicer software to your monitoring software and having all those different things optimized for the printer is what separates us from our competition.
The printer is not one item. It's part of a bigger ecosystem and a bigger set of goals for our users. And so our intent is to really build out a solution that addresses all of those points in the process for them.
For us, it was very important to have all the different departments under one roof.
Having both the design team, engineering team, slicer team, and software development teams all under one roof allowed us to get a lot of great dialogue.
One of the things that I've seen at MakerBot over the last couple years is a pretty intense focus on quality and making sure that the product that we are putting out is really good for the customer.
So we take inputs from Toolpather and feed those back into Mechanical, and we make changes in this feedback loop.
On the gantry for the Replicator Plus, we wanted to increase the speed. So we worked with the Toolpather team to understand whether specific types of moves that they did that we'd have to slow down or just kind of truncate.
Toolpathing is a bunch of commands that literally describe each move that the printer makes. With the redesigned mechanical system for the Replicator Plus, we can print faster because the machine is just solid.
Working collectively together really helped shape this product. Being able to just work together to find a solution within minutes or hours versus weeks or months really helps speed up the design process.
We know there's real value in these printers sitting right where people work, but there's a hurdle that we have to help overcome, and I think the industry has to overcome for desktop printing, both in the classroom and in a professional setting, to really take off. The idea of making the product almost disappear in the workflow is relevant for not just the hardware piece. It has to be quiet, you know, has to be efficient, has to be fast. But it's also true of the software side as well, where the process of bringing in a CAD file needs to be seamless, need to reduce the number of steps, and really help the professionals focus on their work, and not so much on the process of printing.